Boy. Boy. Boy.
All right, here we go. Gardevoir versus Blastoise, the run back. Will Cool Jake pull it all the way back? Or will he switch to another character because he has like millions of them?
Lucario sometimes.
It's a better matchup.
It is a better matchup.
Round one. Right, here we go. Round one of round finals. Trying to bait out the... My brain's failing right now. Cross up. Very nice counter coming out from Yuka. Gaining a little bit of space. Very nice air counter. Hachirisu stopping all those projectiles, forcing Utah on the approach.
Wait.
Oh, that ranged grab, catching him.
When's the monthly?
The monthly's probably next month. Had to burst in order to save his life. Caught in the burst. Wonderful anime watching comment. Oh! So close. Just needs one hit. The problem is...
The problem is that I forgot it does.
Yeah, it in burst, it'll, in field phase, it goes all around-ish. And in duel, it goes whoosh, and it's kind of an anti-air.
Yeah.
Speaking of anti-airs... Oh, thanks, you Cosmo. Oh, caught in the bubble. Both players have burst. Bryce is not feeling well tonight, so he is downstairs. I believe he took some Nyquil so he might be asleep. No, somebody in chat asked about it. Caught by the burst. This burst is glorious, though. Kind of now. Low key black. Hey, oh! Sticking with the Emolga, all the way in round three. Committed a little bit too much to that moment. That's not... That slide was... Oh, that was a nice 6X. But, unlike most of the heavy hitters, I don't know Blastoise moves. Nice moon blast.
Good moon blast.
Caught him a little bit. That's gonna kill. I think he was trying to use the Moonblast to get burst.
Yeah.
But it wasn't quite the best option.
Didn't work out for him in the end.
Boop. Game one going out to Jake. Looks like he might be having a change of supports coming from Utah. I don't think Emolga did too much for him in that. In fact, I barely saw him call it. Miss Magius, Rush Room, counter-piercing things. Things that keep him at a distance and don't make him want to push buttons. He needs to stay back and zone. I will tell him that. Fully charged, counter piercing through the withdrawal. Making it safe. Not safe on that 8X. Yeah. just does Blaster Snap, he gets good big boy combos. Oh, it looks like he thought he was gonna go for the charge. I'm not sure. That counter at that range was pretty dangerous because of that option and the range grab option. That flashed, it was an interesting flash. We might want to call. I thought that was a good time to call Rush Run.
Yeah. Actually, no. Probably the best.
There we go.
That would be good.
That should help the bubble, yes? What? It beat out all those counter frames. All those light hits, but that movement caught got him out of the follow-up. Yutong might be forced to reverse for a bit. No buttons pushed. Burst exhaust. It looks like saved Yutong's life. Pachirisu stopped that combo.
Oh, wait, no.
That is it. Is game two. Grand finals. One more. We have ourselves a reset. And are you talking about Bubble Corp? Because that charges.
I didn't know you could charge.
Like every blaster charges Bubble.
Yeah, you have. It's your best setup. Probably one of the best.
Looks like he's going to try to rely on Burst to try to close things out with Jirachi. Is that song for Jirachi Whip? What is it called?
Wait, with Birdie?
Yeah. I mean, Gardevoir's Burst ain't that bad.
Round one.
Burst. The question is, it's not punishable? Yes. Crazy here all around. That cannot be low profile as far as I know. I don't know why he's trying to go for it. Not dead.
Wow.
Not dead. Yeah, force the burst. Dead. Water gun hydro pump?
Wow.
I think he's talking about the
Yeah, you can charge hydro pump to get extra damage.
Didn't quite catch with that CA counter. CA to CA.
I think that's too wide. Why did you do that?
Counter. That defense debuff is keeping Fujin quite alive.
I love that.
Yes! Moon Blast is literally what makes this match fairly good for Gardevoir, and that reach is ridiculous there. Both players bursting. I'm half surprised that I didn't see the grab. Nice Adex, giving a free space to use the Jirachi. Just go for the swap. Ooh, beating out the power. Catching him on the tip, and that is it. Safe, but Blasters apparently can't punish that well.
Bracket reset.
Bracket reset.
Doris, why do you do this to me?
Should I be afraid?
Probably.
Okay, then I do not want to know. I believe in you. End him.
Round one.
Now, Jake definitely has the right of it to use the Hachirisu, because Gardevoir zoning is what makes this not fun for Blastoise. Didn't quite find the counter right this time. An interesting catch. Again, mistiming counter. I don't think it is.
This is looking a very dominant set right here.
And caught him. Just on the tip. Just a tip.
Got it, having pretty high priority in her counters.
I like my counter because I can move around with it.
Yeah.
Round two.
Getting just a little bit too close before a sideline. It's better to keep away from Blastoise. Staying too close gets you that. Yeah, that wasn't pretty at all. Utah has to show some patience. He cannot sit there and rush Blastoise down. Blastoise has way too much HP, way too many good moves in the close, mid to close range. Because then you'll get situations like that. You have to stay back. Yes, it's been blessing. There we go. Bursting up. Caught by all of that, trying to backdash it. No buttons pressed. Buttons pressed. The synergy buff definitely saving Utah's life. I think
especially
that
there
is just a minor bit of tilt starting to come out on Utah's side.
Kimi no partner te konkai no support pet o erande ne.
The question is, are we going to see another support change? Is it going to go back to the tried and true? He definitely needs something to keep Cool Jake away. Not allow Cool Jake to get close, or at least something that'll allow him that when Cool Jake does get close to grant him a slight reprieve.
Always
kidding. Togekiss is a slightly odd choice. Blastoise takes the air only because Cool Jake is running him.
Yeah.
Alright, we will see how this new support change goes. Very nice. Time to skate a little bit more appropriately this time. Jumping over the projectile. And energy ball being hit. Yep. Backing up a little bit. Whips the grab, but allows him to get that counter in real quick. Now it looks like the momentum is in Utah's favor. Oh no! Kacharisu stopping him from being able to do that combo.
That's the right read, but
punishing the jumpy option. Utah doing a very good job of zoning him out this time. And that is exactly what Utah needed to do. He needs to play the zoning game. He cannot play the close-up game.
Round 2.
See if he keeps it up. I know Utah does not like the zoning game because he feels that it could just screw them in the end. But the shield rating. Just decided to take the damage.
I think it's really smart. I actually like the little mindset that actually yeah. You gotta keep in mind that stuff. So it allows the game to get in much closer. Kyle has a debuff.
Yeah, well, I'm not good at that. I went 1-2, man.
Okay.
That is what he's in this game. Oh no, that is going to connect.
I know that that can destroy you.
Just the chandelier was a bad item. I think it's even on whatever people picked.
Waterbird.
Oh! I gotta wonder if a grab would have been better there. Very nice! Utah not letting... Yes, it is. In reset. Utah telling Cool Jake he can't just run him over.
Why you do this to us? Not in November.
It's because he's been quiet. Corp says he can't really hear you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
How about now?
Talk louder. How about now? I'm speaking louder. My ascension is now becoming.
Alright, we're starting to see some nice zoning coming out from Utah. Not getting close. Commentator bias. Getting the reset and forcing him into the grab. Into the shield.
Now that Pachirisu is online, this is definitely something Kyle has to figure out.
Did I got a question. What happened with Rotom in that moment? Great. It sounded like Rotom tried to connect. Did Pachirisu eat the Rotom?
I think probably Pachirisu probably eats up the So Pachirisu may have lost.
It's always a possibility.
I have to look back.
Very nice 6x.
That normally looks like a boss.
Interesting clash, and I'm not too sure why you went for that. Utah might be forced to burst here in a bit to keep this game going. Yep, here we are. Here's the burst.
Well, if he Pachirisu is online, but
Utah went straight for the homing. Zero fear. Did he go for a button?
Oh my God.
It looks like he did. And that is a raw burst in rage. This should KO. Cool Jake does not have a defensive buff.
No defense buff. Definitely not going to help him out there. But
it looks like Utah found his groove.
getting momentum here, but you may never know, Cool J does could. Have options.
Yes, he does. He could go back to the character screen just like this.
2-1.
He's 2, you're 1. I do believe we are probably going to see a Lucario switch.
Could be.
Probably.
Pikachu.
Yeah. Now the question is he going to stick to the Rotom? Because Rotom could do well in both of those situations.
It could do well, but honestly,
okay, still the Blastoise. Interesting, interesting.
He could be taking a little time to kind of reassure himself and switch up the support. Maybe that can work out. But you know, a lot of players will go back into the character select screen so they can kind of, you know, refresh themselves back in. And we are seeing a support game going off into the Snivy. I understand why they can definitely put Kyle in the game, but we really look at this, it's definitely a situation where I think Hatsuchi was still working out. Like, I just don't think Snivy is going to help this. He's still going to be falling apart.
Yeah. Utah has finally started to zone him a little bit, which means, I mean, unless he's trying to go for a Lapras later on.
It can be the case, but I don't see that happening.
That's not grab punishable by he used it to counterframe Lydia.
Good one. Getting the Hydro Pump combo. Kyle's forcing himself to go into the right.
I do wonder. I don't think that's going to catch.
That one.
It catches. That caught really high.
That.
Excellent. So that is a round one.
I think if we really look at it, that is. It's mostly all this anti air, really.
I kind of expected Utah to, as a counter pierce, I kind of expected Utah to counter it like he had been.
Yeah.
The burst was a good option, though.
Instead of back dash.
You can only forward dash out of Wind Blast.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Oh, gets hit by the bubble there. Put in a very good...
I suppose he was doing it to try to avoid losing burst.
That actually
the question is he going to save burst for game 3 or try to close it out now? You 2x is eaten by that rapid spin.
Yep.
He's got some sort of projectile invulnerability. You have to...
I think Kaya, in this situation, is trying to figure out how to like work. I think, in my opinion, Kyle is better into the field phase, and I think that's really interesting. If he wins the dual phase and sets him back to the field phase, Kyle could definitely win. But it's just a matter of that's there you go.
That's a nice combo.
Yeah, worked out.
So caught by the Snivy. What I would have figured Cool J trying to do is keep on rapid spinning in. I think Utah was actually trying to go for first in there, and that's why the support was so
hot. Yeah. Both of them pulling out the burst. Definitely.
Shielded it.
Good patience from the child. But back at him. That's gonna kill. Not yet. Oh, that does put him in a bad position.
I think Cool J has time to shield right now. Pulling out the Snivy. Not a bad pull, especially with time running out. I think he's trying to go for the shield break, maybe. Oh, caught him. Get in there. That's all he's got to do. Oh! That was extremely close. If that counter had gone all the way through, we might have seen Utah take the win.
Yep.
But that timer, I think Cool Jake was just a little bit more aware of it.
Yep. Now it's 2-2.
This is it. Final game.
Yep. The final game. Winner takes it all.
Round one.
Ooh, started that counter a little bit too early. Alright, let's see if we can see some more zoning coming out.
I think good move last night. Like I said, I think the field phase will work out.
Well, Moonblast cancels all the projectiles, and... Oh, caught, because he was in the middle of the forward line. I think Utah was expecting the grab.
Possibly. Now, Cool Jake has some stuff. He is on a tear right now. Ooh, forward line coming out from Cool Jake. Cool Jake's on set point here.
Well, both players are close to burst. Moonblast won't stop that. It was a very nice air counter, quick thinking. Rapid spin again.
That's a 2-I, but.
I think he was expecting a Rotom to catch that.
Probably, but who knows.
Bursting up.
Yeah, burst off. Cool Jake. Opting
for it. Oh. Yep, that hits in the air. Trying to get in close. Make something happen. Oh, caught in the frames of exhaust.
Oh.
Preventing any button from being pushed, and he expected the grab. And Cool Jake taking a very, very